we getting straight into this motherfucking Eminem Rock and Roll Hall of Fame induction. Patreon sent me the link to watch it. It'd be 35 minutes long, so you know what I'm saying? I ain't got much time to be just jibber jabbing right now. You know what I'm saying? Come and watch this whole shit. Speaking of Patreon though, Revival album review, doing that right now. You know what I'm saying? That's the album review I've been looking forward to doing the most since I started this Eminem journey. So if you want to pull up for that, link for the Patreon is in description box below. Pull up, you know what I'm saying? Fuck with me. And yeah, let's do it. Eminem 2022 Rock and Roll Hall of Fame induction ceremony complete with all songs and speeches. Let's get it.
To induct Eminem, Rock and Roll Hall of Famer, Dr. Dre.
Man, buddy's camera clear as a bitch.
Speech, I asked Eminem if there was anything specific he'd like me to say to everybody, something that he would like them to know. And he said, okay, number one, I want you to tell everybody I have a huge penis. But when he started counting, I was wondering why he decided to use this finger. Over 20 years ago, Jimmy Iovine, who was also one of tonight's inductees and one of my best friends, played a demo tape for me from a guy who called himself Eminem. The first thing I said when I heard it was, what the fuck did he just say? I loved it so much that I couldn't stop listening to it. And a few days later, Jimmy called me up and he said, hey, Trey, you know he's a white guy, right? Completely fucked me up. The last thing I was thinking about when I was listening to the music was that he was a white guy. It never even crossed my mind, but looking back, I don't know why it didn't cross my mind. He certainly didn't sound like a black rapper, especially because of what he was saying. I guess it was my ignorance at the time, thinking that, okay, if you're a good rapper, you must be black, right? Not too long after that, we met for the first time. We hit it off, and the next thing you know, we're in the studio at my house working. The first time I put on a beat, he got on the mic and said, hi, my name is XM Shady.
Yeah. Haley behind me.
Became an amazing creative collaboration. Then came the backlash. Look at him, Dre. This guy has blue eyes. You can't sign him. There was a massive amount of resistance from my own team and people around me that didn't want me to work with him simply because he was white. Didn't want me to sign him or anything like that. While everyone else around me had their doubts, I knew that his gifts were undeniable.
That's right.
That's hard.
Yeah. His raw, dark, humorous lyrics, coupled with an impeccable cadence, stood out from everything I had ever heard before. And he was hungry. Both of us were. We were two artists in do-or-die situations. He was desperate to find a way to feed his family, and I was searching for something that I could sink my teeth into creatively. Each of us were exactly what the other one needed. And I was willing to bet my entire career on that. Yeah, facts. My rebuttal to those naysayers was something like this. He's gonna be the best selling artist on our label. Little did I know, he was gonna be one of the best selling artists of all time. Introduced he skyrocketed to the top of the charts and stayed there for 100 weeks, earning himself a Grammy for Best Rap Album, Best Rap Solo Performance. And can you believe, after promoting violence to little children, killing his daughter's mother, this guy still had more shit to get off his chest? And then his sophomore album comes out, right? The Marshall Mathers LP drops. On that album alone, his alter ego Slim Shady tied me up in the basement. He had sex with his mother, killed his daughter's mother again, while proceeding to offend about every special interest group we had. It clearly struck a chord and became one of the fastest selling albums in United States history.
Yeah, you thought I had the fucking way, man. Shit.
Eminem would go on to overdose, relapse, recover, and not only on his albums, in real life. But let me tell you something. This guy goes through a lot of shit just to get a concept for a song. But here's Eminem's genius. With his incredible wit and wild imagination, he was able to hold a mirror up to white America while also expressing pain through poverty and dysfunctional families devoid of hope. Eminem brought hip-hop to middle America and offered kids who looked like him a way to connect to it.
Oh, this speech is hard, bro. He hit the nail on the head like this shit.
Hip-hop wasn't just for black kids in desperate inner-city circumstances anymore. People of every stripe and color had the art form speak to their struggles also. Eminem wasn't just the underdog who broke through the glass ceiling of hip-hop. He shattered that shit.
Thanks.
Over 220 million albums sold. 13 number one albums, 10 of which all consecutively debuted at number one, making him the first artist to ever achieve this shit. Yeah. Grammy Awards, an Emmy, an Oscar. Yeah, making him the best-selling artist of the 2000s. Best-selling hip-hop artist ever. Let me repeat that. The best-selling hip-hop artist ever. And the crazy part about it is he doesn't even really care about that. I think I care about it more than he does, you know? What's most important to him is that he's earned the respect of his peers as one of the best to ever do it. Point blank. Turns out, this unassuming white guy with blue eyes from Detroit being repeatedly turned down and turning everything we thought we knew about hip hop on his head while forcing us to confront our own biases,
Facts. Going
not only the genre, but all of us right along with it.
That's right.
Still motherfuckers hate money. That was a hard ass speech. That was a hard ass speech.
I was in the Rap Olympics. The kids from Interscope were there, and they got the tape. And Jimmy Iovine, he liked it, and he played it for Dre.
He popped the tape in and said, "Yo, Dre, check this out. Tell me what you think." I listened to it and I was like, yo, I need to work with him like yesterday, you know? And I had a studio in my house at the time and I invited him over to hit one of my joints.
Yeah.
And I hit the drum machine and maybe 2 or 3 seconds went by and he just went, hi, my name is. And I'm listening to this shit and I am all the way confused. Black people don't talk like this. He's tired. Go grind your dick, jump off a tree.
Hi kids, do you like violence? Wanna see me stick 9-inch nails to each one of my eyelids?
But this guy is the biggest freak I've ever worked with. So that's why I like Click, you know what I mean?
He was like, he dope. But then when we heard him after Dr. Dre produced his album, was like, damn, he's super dope.
Slim Shady already sparked quite a controversy in some quarters.
I don't like it, don't buy it.
I mean, very violent, very sexist, and all that, and homophobic. But that record was amazing.
They can't tell me that I can't do the music that I love.
They would hate his ass now, boy. Eminem wouldn't be able to exist now. You can't even post a damn documentary you want to see on Twitter, dog. The likes of Eminem, he wouldn't have lasted a second, bro.
And it's supported from since I was like 9 years old. You know what I mean? That's ridiculous.
We've been waiting pantyhose, sing the chorus, and they go.
Anything else in this world. Give it everything.
This is your moment.
His buddy been holding this shit in his hand the whole time. He was a fucking tripod, cuz. Well, I'm really tired. Yeah, that was hard as fuck, though. Yes. Are they gonna make Eminem perform at his own induction?
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to induct my friend Eminem into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
So bad, about. If he ever saw him again, he'd probably knock him out. His thoughts are wet, he's mad, so he's talking back. Talking black, brainwashed from Rocky Grant. He sank his pants, blue rags, and a stocking cap. His stepfather hit him, so he socked him back and broke his nose. His house is a broken home, there's no control. He just lets his emotions go. Come on!
That's lit. Steven Tyler can still sing too. That's crazy. You got Ed Sheeran out here. they stunting. They stunting. This is lit, bro.
And my home phone at the bottom. I sent two letters back in autumn. You must not have got them. There probably was a problem in the post office or something. Sometimes I scribble addresses too sloppy when I got them. But anyways, fuck it, what's been up? Man, how's your daughter? My girlfriend's pregnant too. I'm about to be your father. If I have a daughter, guess what I'ma call her? I'ma name her Bonnie. I read about your Uncle Ronnie too, I'm sorry. I had a friend kill himself over some bitch you didn't want him. I know you probably hear this every day. I'm the biggest fan. You got the underground shit that you think was scam. I got a room full of your posters and your pictures, man. I like the shit you did, but wrong is too. That shit was fair. Anyways, I hope you get this thing. Hit me back. The chat, truly yours, your biggest fan. This is shit. A tease gone caught up on you.
That picture, man. Post that shit on YouTube, bro. Put your
picture on the wall. It reminds me that it's not so bad. It's not so bad. Make some noise, man. Sharing you.
Hey, welcome out, Hall of Fame. Y'all still with us? Make some noise.
Oh, shit. So Drake ain't gonna pull up. Somebody gotta pull up to this fucking feature, man. Fucking that bitch, what is that?
Follow me. I'll get you there. Let's go.
lyrics off of this paper before I say them. But you will take a sting out these words before I say them. This ain't the way I'm gonna let you stop me from causing me. When I say I'm gonna do something, I do it. I don't give a damn what you think. I do this for me. Fuck the world, feed it beans. Gassed up, and you think you're stopping me. I'ma be what I set out to be without a doubt.
Concert for real, bro. Your camera, bro.
Possible. I'm fucking stuttering and shit. So I'm probably not supposed to actually be here tonight because of a couple of reasons. One, I know that I'm a rapper. This is the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And there's only a few of us right now that have been inducted in already. But there's only a few of us. Secondly, almost died from an overdose in 2007, which kind of sucked because, Haley, plug your ears. Because drugs were fucking delicious. And I thought we had a good thing going, man, but I'm like, I had to go and fuck it all up, take too many. God damn. Okay, Haley, you're good. So, spot. Paul, I said drugs were delicious, right?
Yeah.
And finally, I had to really fight my way through, man, to try to break through in this music, and I'm so honored and I'm so grateful that I'm even able to be up here doing hip-hop music, man, because
yes!
I love it so much, and they say that, you know, you won't work a day if you love your job and shit.
We love you!
This part, I'm not crazy about.
He's so fucking humble, bro.
But okay, my musical influences are many, and they say it takes a village to raise a child. Well, it took a whole genre and culture to raise me. They say success has many fathers, and that's definitely true for me. So whatever my impact has been on hip-hop music, I never would have or could have done this shit without groundbreaking artists, some of the groundbreaking artists that I'm about to mention right now. And this is a list, man. I put this list together yesterday, and I kept adding to the shit. And if I forget anybody, I apologize, but these were my teachers right here. I'm gonna start with the 2 Live Crew. Tupac. Third Base, Alliance, Apache, Audio 2, Milk D, what up? Awesome Dre. The Beastie Boys. Big Daddy Kane. Big Pun.
You got it in alphabetical order, don't you?
Big L. Biz Markie. Mm. The Notorious B.I.G., of course. Black Moon. The Boogie Monsters. Brand Nubian. Brother J from X-Clan.
No, most.
Buckshot.
Most of the shit Casual he's saying, nobody knows. Fucking student.
Chuck Rock. Chuck D. And Public Enemy. Cypress Hill. D-Nice. Dana Dane. De La Soul. Nah, I'm about four with him. De La Soul. Did I say De La Soul? Def Jeff. Tell the Funky Homo Sapien. Whoa. DJ Quick. Yeah. Dr. Dre. Dress of Black Sheep. NOG. EPMD. Fat Boys. Fat Joe. Foosh Nickens. Gangstar. Ghetto Boys. Heavy D. House of Pain. Ice Cube. Ice T. The Intelligent Hoodlum.
It was hard as fuck. JJ Fan. I keep saying that, but it is.
Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. Just Us. K Solo. Kid and Play.
And they say Eminem ain't culture, bro. I bet the majority of the people who represent the culture don't even know 90% of the shit he's fucking saying. I know I don't know a lot of the motherfuckers he's saying, but you know what I'm saying? I don't be out here got, y'all know where I stand on this shit. For how I rock with Eminem right now. Or how much I fuck with Eminem, dog, and all that hatred and shit he get for being a white boy not representing the culture, bro. Hey, what about him isn't culture, bro? You know what I mean? Fucking, it just irritates me when I fucking think about it, dog.
King Son, King T, Cool G Rap, Cool D, KRS-One, Kwame, Hakim Shabazz, Large Professor, Leaders of the New School, and my man right under the scene, the one and only LL Cool J. Master Ace, MC Breed, MC Light, MC Shan, Melly Mel, Merciless Amir, Mobb Deep, Money Love, Nas, Nucleus, Onyx, Organized Confusion, Outkast, Andre 3000, Paris, Farside, Queen Latifah, Rakim, Redhead Kingpin, Pete Rock and CL Smooth. Almost done. Redman, Roxanne Shante, Run DMC, Sam Pepper, Slick Rick and Dougie Fresh, Snoop Dogg, Souls of Mischief, Special Ed, Stetsasonic, now I'm down to the S's, huh? Super Legacy and Casanova Rudd, the DLC, the Roots, Black Dog, the Skinny Boys, Tony D, Too Short, Tragic Naughty by Nature, Tribe Called Quest, UTFO, Houdini, Wise Intelligent and the Poor Righteous Teachers, Wu-Tang Clan, and Run D. Yo, those were my rock stars, man, and I just want to say, like, those are just a few of the names that I hope will be considered in the future for induction because without them, a lot of us wouldn't be here. So, that's all I need to say, man. I know that this induction is supposed to be me, like, talking about myself and shit, man, but fuck that. I would not be here without them, and, I'm a high school dropout, man, with hip-hop education, and these are my teachers. And it's their night just as much as it is mine. So thank you.
Yeah. That was hard, bro. I felt like I was at the goddamn concert. Hope y'all felt like y'all was there too, man. And watch them end up posting the actual footage from the fucking award show. But watch that shit too. Anyway, man, I hope y'all like that.